I suppose a lot of my work has been informed by my my upbringing, my background, which was within the environment of the west coast of Scotland, a small town called Dunoon. You've got nature happening every day out your window. You also got things like submarines passing up and down the glade. When I've been making work, I've been sort of trying to, in a sense, come to terms with these two things, that we live in a technological age, but we are also surrounded by this ancient natural beauty. I've actually become interested in interactive media because it allows you to sample from the environment in different ways. I've tried to incorporate that kind of interactivity into public artworks as well, so that instead of just making a sculpture for a public space, I'm making a sculpture that's also got a kind of life of its own, in a sense. I was thinking of this idea of feedback and the environment feeding the artwork. I wanted to introduce something that was bigger and beyond the actual space itself. The idea to tap into the earth via the internet and to take in seismic data, which would then be used to trigger the artwork. It's taken over 2 years to actually develop it. The piece is called Beneath and Beyond, and the idea behind the title is that it's basically what's happening beneath your feet, and the information and the data and the activity is coming beyond the horizon. Places like San Diego, Australia, Japan, Poland, wherever, it's actually tapping into the computers that monitor the seismology activity under the ground. And that can range from tectonic plate shifting or just the general sort of molten movement beneath the crust. It's accessing that data, bringing the data in live. The data is basically vibrations. It's happening in the earth. We can't hear what these sounds are because of such low frequency, there's such low frequency vibrations. But if we speed up the vibration, then we can hear it. So that's what the computer does, it speeds up the vibration, makes it into sound. So what we're hearing is kind of like the sound as it's arrived and then being compressed, so there's a slight delay, you know, but it is live because it's kind of like it's a streaming process, you know. There's another program, it's called, it's using Max MSP, and what that does is it basically organises the sound to be played out through the amplifiers and the speakers and controls the sound so it can basically move within the space. You'll always hear different types of sort of low frequency backgrounds happening through the four big speakers. And then there's what we call events, and there are things where something significant, more significant happens. Where the event occurs, that's highlighted by a kind of red block, and we pick that up, and that's played through six small speakers. A lot of times they're playing at the same time, they're meeting on a playhead, and what happens then is then you start getting a kind of composition, an arrangement, but it's the earth in a sense that's making the arrangement, you know. Through broadband, all I need from any kind of exhibition venue is a broadband cable into the back of a PC in order to make this happen, and the program does the rest. Although it's a very contemporary sort of art, technology, nature piece, it's also within a tradition of artists working in relation to landscape in the broadest sense. So I see a connection between that, and this is taking into the like, 21st century. Not that technology is something within itself, because technology has been used for, you know, not for the best purposes all the time. At the moment, the kind of ecological debate is a lot more to the forefront. Also, the kind of destructive element in human nature is to the forefront as well. And one sense, this piece allows people to meditate in a sense of what is going on, and to actually to try to reconnect and think about the earth. Well, it's very much about the real experience that you get in the space. And it's important that people realise that what they hear, what they see, is happening in real time. And I think having the data projected on the screen, and then its waveforms, associated with waveform of the sound, and the name of the country appearing, gives that kind of information to the viewer that they're actually experiencing what's happening.
Thank you.